Welcome to this Q&A of the day video in association with TLC Electrical Wholesaler, renowned for quality, value and customer service. In today's video, we're going to be considering a subject brought up by a video in our recent live feed event that related to some industrial isolators manufactured by Lewden. We're going to answer the following question. Is it acceptable to lock an isolator in the on position? Now, this is an interesting one. The first thing we need to establish is, why would you want to? Well, maybe you've got a piece of equipment that's at risk of being tampered with in an accessible location. You may want to lock the isolator in the on position so that nobody switches it off in a spirit of mischief or malice. But will the regulations allow this? Well, section 537 of BS 7671 does offer some insight into this question. It's the section that deals with selection and erection of isolation and switching. So does it contain any information on locking isolators in the on position? Well, not explicitly in connection with preventing tampering, but there is a little hint in regulation 537.2.5 where it states, provision shall be made for securing offload isolating devices against unwanted or unintentional opening. So opening here means switching the isolator into the off position. It continues, this may be achieved, for example, by locating the device in a lockable space or lockable enclosure, or by padlocking. Alternatively, the offload device may be interlocked with a load breaking one. So let's just be clear here, from this regulation, it's referring to a very specific situation, namely using offload switching devices for isolation. An offload device being one that's designed to disconnect a circuit, but not while current is flowing through it. This reg is designed to keep the installation safe by making it harder to operate an offload switching device while there's current flowing through it. So it's not exactly applicable to our question, but it shows that padlocking an isolator in the on position isn't necessarily outlawed and actually hints at an underlying principle for our consideration. How? Well, let's look at table 537.4. You can see here we've got different devices and their associated BSEN numbers and an indication as to whether they can be used for isolation, emergency switching, or functional switching. So an isolating switch conforming to BSEN 60947-3 could potentially be used for isolation, emergency, and functional switching as long as it complies with the relevant other regulations in this section. However, to answer our original question, we need to look at what function the isolator is performing. We saw in regulation 537.2.5 there is allowance in BS 7671 to padlock an isolator in the on position. However, if the switching device is being used for emergency switching, then logic would suggest that there is absolutely no way that you should padlock it in the on position, as this could slow down the switching process in an emergency. So to summarise the answer, you may well be able to lock an isolator in the on position, depending on what purpose the isolating device is serving. Thank you very much for watching.